So I was in the process of getting this panel ready for a completely unrelated video. I sprayed some silver on about a third of the panel, and I thought this would be a great opportunity to show you guys a very quick and easy method to create a brushed aluminum effect. So here's what I've got. You can see I've sprayed a third of this panel with a silver. This is Autoborn's silver sealer. Now it doesn't matter which silver you use to create this effect. Any silver will work. It doesn't matter if it's a fine metallic or a medium metallic or a coarse metallic. The Autoborn silver sealer is a little bit more of a coarse. It's got a lot of metallic in this silver. It's a really good color. So I chose to use the Autoborn silver sealer for this particular panel, but again, you can use any silver metallic will work. Once I had the Autoborn silver sealer sprayed, then I came over the top of that with two to maybe three coats of UVLS gloss clear. The gloss clear is simply to protect the actual metallic particles in the silver sealer, because we're going to be scratching the surface and I don't want to scratch the actual metallic flakes that are in the silver. So I've got a protective barrier, so to speak, over the metallic. The next step in the process is to begin scratching the surface. You can do that with either a red Scotch-Brite pad, or I prefer to use steel wool. What we're going to do is not scuff the surface for adhesion purposes. So normally, if I were scuffing the surface for adhesion purposes, I would be working in a crosshatch pattern. You don't want to do that for this particular technique. You want to work in one direction only. So I'm going to take my steel wool and begin scuffing this surface just up and down. I want to keep it as straight as possible. I'm not using a lot of pressure, but I am using some pressure. You don't want to press extremely hard, and you can see I'm keeping this very straight up and down and putting minor scratches into the surface. And my goal is to pretty much cover the entire surface. So I'm taking that shine from the clear coat away, just like I would do if I were prepping a surface for paint, with the exception of I'm keeping it very straight. All of these strokes are straight up and down because we're going for that brushed aluminum look. That's pretty good. Once I've got the surface scuffed or scratched to a point that I like it, I'm going to take a tack rag and clean off any residual clear. And at this point, we're ready for the next step in the process, which is adding some transparent black. I'm going to be using Auto Air transparent black. You can use the Wicked Detail Black or the Wicked Detail Smoke Black or even the Illustration Black. All of those are transparent by nature, but they're not going to be as transparent as the Auto Air Transparent Black. So you will want to reduce it a little bit more. You want a good transparent black for this part of the process. I've reduced the Auto Air Black, the transparent black, down to about my normal reduction ratio, which is 1:1. So I've got one part of the Auto Air transparent black and about one part of 4011 reducer. So it should be very transparent. And it is. So at this point, I'm going to apply some streaks of this black onto our silver base coat. Again, I'm going to keep it very straight, or as straight as I can keep it. And I'm going to spray a little bit randomly. I don't want to just cover the entire silver portion of the panel uniformly. I want it to be somewhat chaotic. You can see I put a few darker streaks in there, but for the most part, it's relatively light. So at this point, you want to make sure that the black that you've sprayed onto the surface is at least dry to the touch. You don't need to allow this to sit for 30 minutes to an hour to really cure. I just want it dry to the touch, which should be relatively quick because we put this on extremely light. And then we're going to go back to either your Scotch-Brite pad or your steel wool pad. And we're going to do the same thing we just did a few minutes ago, putting scratches into the surface in a very straight formation. This time I'm not going to use as much pressure. Wipe it down one more time with a tack rag. And that's really pretty much it for this particular effect. It's a super simple method to create a nice brushed aluminum effect. Essentially what we're doing is when you come in with either your Scotch-Brite pad or your steel wool for the first scratching session, what you're doing is creating, on a microscopic level, very nice little grooves for paint to settle into. So when we spray the transparent black over the surface, some of that paint is going to fall into those grooves and remain. Some of it is going to remain more on the surface. So when we come back over the surface with either the Scotch-Brite pad or the steel wool pad, and I do prefer to use steel wool for this particular effect. Either method will work, but I think steel wool gives it just a little bit better finish in the end. But when we come back over the surface with the steel wool or the Scotch-Brite, you're actually removing some of the paint that's on the surface, but some of the paint that is down in those grooves remains, and it gives us a really nice brushed aluminum effect. So off camera, I'll throw a couple coats of UVLS clear onto this one more time, and then I'll come back just so you guys can kind of see what it looks like with a clear coat applied. Unfortunately, it gets dark ridiculously early where I'm at this time of year, so I can't show you guys this panel outside under the sun, but I did shine a flashlight on it here in the studio, and you can really see how much metallic is in this Autoborn Sealer silver. It's a lot. In fact, from a direct view, outside under good lighting, you would actually lose the brushed aluminum effect because the metallic particles just take over. But from a sidecast view, you really get a crystal clear view of that brushed aluminum effect. It looks pretty cool. And the effect is a little bit different depending on the metallic silver you use. You can change this up however you want. Again, if you use a fine metallic silver, I think the effect is actually more true to a true brushed aluminum, whereas the medium and the coarse metallics kind of tend to take over when the sun hits it. Sometimes I don't even use a clear coat barrier before I begin scratching the surface, especially on a fine metallic silver. I think it looks cool to go ahead and just etch the actual metallic particles. You can put more of the transparent black streaks in it, or you can take away more of the transparent black streaks when you go back over it with either your Scotch-Brite pad or the steel wool. It's completely up to you as the artist. This is just a pretty quick, easy, simple method that I use to create a brushed aluminum effect, but you can change it up however you see fit. This is just a starting point, or you can do it exactly like I did. It's completely up to you as the artist again. So I hope you guys have got something out of this. If you did, remember to like, subscribe, and share. I'll leave links in the description below to all the products that I used in this particular video. I'm Trevor with Wicked Art Studio, and I'll see you guys next time.